Floor beer.
Floor beers. Mm. Mm. Keeps them cool down there because heat rises, you see.
Ah.
It's all science, mate. It's all science. Good evening, Jousters, and welcome to the Joust, ladies and gentlemen. I am your host, Liam McNeil, and I'm joined this week not by Nagy, but by a vital cog in the music-making machine that is Narmate. Sam, welcome back to the show.
Thanks for having me.
Now, what has happened since we last saw you? You've turned 30, I've heard.
I have turned 30. I've also turned into you. You've turned into Nagy. It's been a whole thing.
It's been a whole thing, but easy adjustment period, or how's it going?
Yeah, no, it was all right. Hitting 3, I wasn't as scary as they make it believe. I mean, you wake up and your back hurts, and I think that's just what you get. It's
that's
rite
just
of passage.
So. Well, yeah, I've recently turned 30 as well, and I'm finding much the same thing.
Yeah,
it's good. Very much a similar situation for both of us, I think. But you got a pretty handy reward on your 30th birthday, courtesy of Brad Fittler and his New South Wales Blues.
I did. It was a present came in very weird wrapping. I had no idea what to expect when he gave me that present, but it turned out to be wonderful.
Well, they end up usually the best presents, those ones where you don't know. They're not on the list you've given people. They're a weird shape, and they're kind of sometimes wrapped in newspaper. You never know what you're going to get, but they're the best ones. So obviously the New South Wales Blues getting up 38-6 in our second round of footy Christmas, and mate, what a game it was. What an absolutely barnstorming performance from the Blues.
It was crazy, really, just think about just how all the opinions about the team going into the game, and then just to see what happened. It was just crazy. It helped that Queensland didn't really show up.
Didn't it?
If that could happen again, that would, I mean, it doesn't make for much of a spectacle, but yeah, just everything he did clicked.
Yeah, the Freddy magic has paid off. I mean, New South Wales, they were just dominant all over the park. They had 59% possession. They completed at 83%. I was a bit hesitant seeing 4 second rowers on the bench, but I don't know. It worked somehow.
Yeah, I know. Like, and the centres, just you can play anyone out of position.
Yeah.
That's why I'm you and you're Nagy.
Yeah, exactly.
It's a week for that, I think.
Freddie's really inspired us, don't you think? He's laid the platform for us beautifully.
Executive producer of the Joust.
He is. He's a dear friend of the show. He listens every week and, you know, regular contributor. So, Freddie, thank you very much. But, yeah, look, it was just an unbelievable victory. And hats off was one of the toughest hats off I've had to pick in a long time. So I picked two. I picked Tomas Trbojevic, who got 88% of the vote with 3 tries, 118 metres, 4 tackle busts and a line break. He was just everywhere.
Yeah,
they
nice.
Kind of said, you know, he couldn't play centre. He's not a centre, but he did it.
Yeah, no, it just seems to be you can pick guys that are talented and they just slot in there. It doesn't really take much. I mean, I've never played centre before in my life either. I'm sure it would be much tougher for me, but for a guy like Tom Trbojevic, I think it'd just be pick it up like that, really.
So. Well, it was all effort. That's what everyone was talking about in the aftermath of the game. It was all effort plays, and they had him playing almost a second fullback role.
Yeah, I know.
Just a roving commission.
That leap over our boy Ponga.
Oh.
Well, Pong Strong. That was just something else. Just made him look like he wasn't really there. That's not the Ponga I know.
That's not the Ponga we know and love, no. But it's the Ponga we like to see in Origin,
yeah, exactly,
isn't it?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. In that colour, he can do whatever he wants.
Absolutely.
Shit the bed as hard as he likes.
Yeah, but I mean, I could have picked any number of players for hats off and they would have swept in. We had Josh Adokar with 215 metres, 2 tries, 2 tackle busts, a line break assist. Teddy Tedesco had 2 try assists. Maloney, 2 try assists. Jake Turbo, 158 metres, 30 post-contact metres, 30 tackles for no misses. Any of them would have been very comfortable having our hats taken off to them.
Well, I just think James Maloney, there has to just be something special set aside for him just to do what he did, just to come in and go, nope, my team, we're going this way.
He's got it. I don't know what it is.
I don't think he knows what it is.
But he's got it.
He just does it. Yeah, every time. He's got a look. One's eyes looking that way, the other's eyes looking that way. And he just sees everything that's happening, and if it doesn't pay off, he just goes, all right, reset the table, I'll go again.
Also, he seems to have mystery scabs on his face. Have you noticed that?
I think he just does that getting up in the morning. Just rolls over, hits the bed, oop, go back to sleep, I'll do it again.
And then wins. He gets out of bed and he wins.
He's a winner.
No, he was immense. And especially with Nathan Cleary going off with an injury, didn't come back out for the second half.
Wade Graham just coming in, just slotting in at 5'8".
He was superb.
He's just, he doesn't look like much.
He doesn't, does he?
But he's just silky.
He's got a bit of a gut still.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. ACLs are no joke, so I'm assuming that didn't help him, but he came back and he was, just fitted straight back
in. Oh, mate, he was incredible. And that leads to the talk of game 3 with Nathan Cleary going to be out.
Yes.
Who will play in the halves? Now, is it Mitch Pearce? Is it
Do we have
Luke
a Mitch Pearce klaxon, do we? Like selection klaxon? Is there something like
it's the Mitch Pearce Glocken.
Yeah,
we Glocken spiel when we discuss Pearce for Origin. Do you think Mitch Pearce should come back for Origin?
Well, him and Maloney have done it before. For the Roosters, not so much for the Origin. God rest his soul. But so I think it's not the worst idea in the world. And the talk is that they put Pierce to six and put Maloney to seven, which I don't mind either. Just let Maloney run his thing. If he starts just going off the boil, then Pierce is a steadying influence. I mean, he doesn't have Thurston there to ruin his life.
Thurston, Kronk, Smith, GI.
So he won't even know himself. Yeah. So I think that would probably be the strongest one. But then again, Wade Graham did so well at six, you could just, you know. What was it? What was old mate Sean? Was it Timmins back in the day?
Sean Timmins,
the old six for the kick, the field goal,
From 40 meters out,
a bit like that old Wade.
I'd forgot about Sean Timmins. He does have an air of Timo about him,
and he was in the six, straight six. So maybe that is the way.
Yeah, and he was one of the bigger ball playing sixes. I remember he was great, Sean Timmins. Mm. So I think you're right. I think Wade Graham to six could be an excellent move.
And leave us alone, you know. Let Pierce just carry us through this thing.
That would be the ideal result. Yeah, let Pierce just get us through. Focus on his Knights games, and we don't worry about Origin now.
Yeah, exactly.
Are bound to worry about Origin because we're warriors when it comes to Origin, and it's a very stressful time of year, but the stress has been lifted for another week, 2 weeks and a half.
Yeah, now we can all breathe again, unclench. It's nice.
Do you have any bolters for game three?
Bolters? I think it's more Queensland have got to try and find some forwards from somewhere because that, I think, is what happened. We just ate them in the forwards. They just couldn't do anything because with a team like that, with the halves and spine that they have, it doesn't make sense for them to constantly suck. So I think it was just the fact that they lost some two big dudes and once that happened, they just didn't have anything to go against our guys. So I guess you got Clemmer coming back, which is the big one. He's not a bolter, but it's the people that you have to leave out more than the people you got to put back in, which is a nice place to be.
And more to come with that in the sack later. Now we'll look ahead to next week. Next week, the Knights are at home to the Brisbane Broncos. Now, both teams are coming off the back of losses. The Broncos have lost their last two, but they're sitting back in 12th position. Mm. But I worry about the Broncos. I do worry about them because they've got that really, really good young forward pack. They've got a few very handy backs, but their spine just doesn't seem to have clicked so far. But if it does click, which it has a few times throughout the season, they could be really dangerous.
Well, they like getting a new spine every week, don't they?
Yeah.
They don't know who the hooker is. They don't know who the halfback is. I mean, Anthony Seibold... shit all over that guy they got from the Roosters
Sean O'Sullivan.
And then had to play him. And then he went awful. Go figure. I mean, it's just... So that, I'm a little bit, you know, it's a good time to get him, I think, because you got Milford in there. I mean, he just won with Samoa or whatever, but he still doesn't have a halfback, and he really needs that kind of controlling halfback just to let him do his thing. And then Darius is 30 going on 80, and...
He's cooked, isn't he? Surely they've got to give him a rest.
And if it's wet, like it's pouring down right now, I don't know if you can pick that up during the microphones, but... If it's wet, the turning circle on Darius Boyd is worse than my Magna of old. It was absolutely horrendous. So I reckon it's a good time to get him. And they've got a couple of forwards coming back, I think, the Broncos.
Yeah, they do. Payne Haas is coming back. They've got all their Origin stars have been named to back up.
Offen Gowie's back as well.
Offen Gowie's back. Yeah, Gillett, Oates and Fifita have all been named. Mm. But the big inclusion for us is David Clemmer. Now, he's been named in the number 19 jersey. But with Josh King and Pasami Solo on the bench, I wouldn't be surprised to see one of them drop out and the Clem come in and take one of their spots.
Yeah, broken wrist and back in 3 weeks.
Isn't it amazing? This new head of high performance, Baylen Couples, he's got some sort of strange secret.
Yeah, just a bunch of wrists down in the
in
the storage shed. There you go, Dave. Try one on. Come back. New man.
He got plenty to spare, and why wouldn't you? Why wouldn't you?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, he should be great. I mean, if Saifidi should be... full of head steam coming back from that, because I had my fears about old Daniel.
I was a bit worried too. He's only a young boy being thrust into an important position.
And he's mad for dropping a kickoff. I had a recurring nightmares of him dropping that opening hit up. But then he came back and ruined Kevin Walters' night from the get-go.
He had a beauty, didn't he? We didn't discuss Daniel Saifidi. We should have, being a Knights themed podcast and all. We completely forgot to discuss Daniel Saifidi.
Oh, big DSAF. But yeah, first hit up was fantastic, and he set up that try later in the game, later in the first half. So, yeah, great stuff.
I just loved when he came out and said in the press, I want the first hit up. I want to have that first hit up. That impressed me.
That scared me. I was like, just don't drop it, Daniel.
See, that showed me that he's ready for Origin.
That's true.
It was like, I was about to use a Jack DeBellin story, but I shan't.
No.
Because we don't talk about him anymore.
Yeah, we'll just censor it out. just come across.
Oh, well, that's all for next week. What's coming up now in the news?
Ooh.
Hang on, sorry.
Why not? I gotta grab a cup, don't I?
There we go. Nagy usually does this. I don't know the buttons.
That's a sack.
That is sack? The sack. Yes, now the sack. We'll start with Daniel Turner and what we've just touched on. What do you do with Saifidi if Clemmer is fit for Origin 3?
Well, it's kind of a hard one, isn't it? Because he was Clemmer's replacement. But we do have four second rowers on the bench. I mean, surely you want a backup prop in there. You can't just make Jake Trbojevic do everything in the middle there. It works.
Well, he did it. He did it well.
Yeah, he probably can keep doing it. Yeah, it might be a really, really tough one. It might be... Sorry, Daniel, but maybe next year.
See, the idea I heard on NRL 360 that I quite like was what we discussed just now. Wade Graham coming into 5'8". That leaves a hole on the bench. Saifidi and Clemmer to start with Paul Vaughan on the bench.
What if you get some sort of injury then? If, say, Maloney gets hit in the head by that dog Josh Maguire again.
Well, then we're screwed. Yeah.
Graham playing 7 and... Cameron Murray in 6.
It's a very all or nothing ploy that we're going with there. But Origin's all about all or nothing.
Yeah, well, you know, Sean Timmins did it back in the day where Graham can just be the man.
Exactly. He can and he will. If anything, he can and he will. So I think you keep Saifidi in. But again, it depends on who you pick in that number 7 or that number 6. Isaac Hebblewhite asks if Daniel Saifidi deserves another stint, but also mentions that he was caught out of position otherwise on several occasions, but was solid otherwise. But yeah, Isaac, I think we keep him in, but...
He's still very young. I mean, against the Melbourne game, leading into Origin, he kind of went missing a little bit. So, you know, he did a bit hot and cold, and I think he will just, you know, love this experience and should go to another level from having it. But whether or not he's... You can fit him into that third team. I don't know. I'll wait to be seen.
He'll have plenty more chances in the future, though. I think it's safe to say. Now, Liam Jones asks, did you think it was possible for Queensland to have another captain as unlikable as Cam Smith? They sure showed us. So what do you reckon? DCE on the scale of unlikability, with Cam Smith obviously leading the pack right up the top, where do you think DCE fits into this?
Well, they could have made Josh Morris captain, couldn't they?
Josh Morris?
Oh, no, sorry, Josh Maguire, sorry.
I was going to say, if Josh Morris was captain, I'd follow
him. I don't need to get his name right. He hasn't earned that privilege. Yeah. Well, it was funny, actually, when the series started and they were wondering about who could be captain, it was really funny. They were just like, do we make Cameron Munster captain? It seemed to just be a vacuum in terms of captaincy, because they were like... Give it to DCE. We hate him. We've hated him for a very long time, but we just give him the keys to the place, and that's what they went with. It just kind of spoke to me, just a lack of kind of leadership options
now,
in Queensland.
Sam, I've got to be quite honest with you. I don't particularly hate DCE. I really don't. I don't know. I understand why that a lot of people do, and they seem to think it's because he can string a sentence or two together.
They frown on that.
I find that a fairly admirable quality in a human being. So I'm not sure I get the hate behind DCE. So for me, Cam Smith will still be the ultimate.
Well,
the ultimate hate machine.
Well, when he came into the team, he had Cooper Cronk there, and who's another talker. They didn't mind him as a talker, but he was coming from Manly with Anthony Watmau and Brett Stewart, and they weren't getting along with them. And that, to me, is kind of a badge of honour, really.
Yeah, if you can't get along with Manly players, you're doing all right.
Exactly. So, you know, I don't particularly have any real hate for him. I mean, he's got a very punchable face.
Oh, I won't deny that, but I can't hate a man based purely on his face.
Yeah,
I know.
Some people have to have punchable faces. That's a lie. Stop us getting punched in the face.
Yeah, exactly. I am that shallow, actually. I would hate someone for their face. Now, Dylan Smith asks, is it better for Mitchell Pearce to miss State of Origin this year? Physically and mentally, I believe it's better for him to focus just on club footy. I think, yes, it's better for him to miss it. He's put his hand up and said that he will play today. He was interviewed, I believe, in the Daily Telegraph. He's put his hand up and said, yes, I will play. But I think for Mitchell's sake and the Knights' sake, I say, yeah, give him a rest. Let him just focus on the season with the Knights and not be distracted by Origin, because it will be a big distraction for him, I think.
Yeah, for sure. The selfish Knights fan in me wants him to just stay and guide us to this wonderful run home that we have. Have you seen that run home?
I have.
It is amazing.
It's excellent.
The best team we play is the Roosters once, and then it's Manly, who are 8th. And it's just like, alrighty then. It's fantastic. So if he could just do that and just run over all those guys, that'd be fantastic. But another part of me thinks, come back, partner Maloney, win Origin.
Would that be...
just win the whole series on one game, put it all in.
Would that be redemption enough for all the bad years that we won't talk about?
Well, you've got a photo with him with a trophy, and that's all you need. And it's like, that'll be enough, surely.
That's it, one and done. Yeah. All right, one and done. So we're split on that one. Chris John asks, there is no way Queensland can come back in Origin 3 after that, can they?
Oh, well, we said that about New South Wales, didn't we?
We did, yeah.
I love the battle of the coaches, by the way. I'll just short thing. This is like two bloody kooks just going out and trying to out-kook each other. That's fantastic. But I just think there's a... lack of depth in the forwards for Queensland.
So. And in the outside backs. They've got one centre.
Well, you don't need a centre to play centre.
Well, apparently not, yeah. It seems to work for New South Wales. It didn't work too well for Queensland, though.
And Morgan got injured as well, didn't he? Michael Morgan. I'm pretty sure he's not playing for the Cowboys this weekend, I don't think, anyway. So I just think that we've just got way bigger bodies and to roll through them.
And
so,
better bodies.
Yeah.
We're a much better looking team as well.
Exactly. David Clemmer, there's a model.
Oh, mate, absolutely. But at the same time, the Origin fan in me, you know, I've been watching Origin for a long time. You can't rule Queensland out. No matter what they do, no matter how much they lose by, you can never rule Queensland out.
We've got to stop writing them off because that's just making them go, oh, we're just going to win all the harder.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. That's been a trap we've fallen into in the past, Sam. We've fallen into that and written them off. And what happened?
It makes us stop caring a little bit. Mm-hmm. It makes us stop, just die a little bit on those, like, 1% plays or whatever. Just like, nah, we'll
which
be
you
right.
can't afford to do in Origin.
No.
Now, Katrina O'Brien next. What is the real honest to God truth why Danny Levi is not wanted at the Newcastle Knights?
It's a weird one, isn't it?
It is a doozy because he's shown that he can be an excellent hooker. He can be a very good player. He's been in excellent form this year and yet the club's still shopping him around.
Well, if you had to choose between Danny Levi and Jaden Brayley, I'd go Danny Levi.
I'd go Danny Levi as well.
Mm. And then I really like what Connor Watson's doing at 9. Mm. I think that's fantastic. Danny Levi does have a brain snap or two when he's game. Mm. But so does Mitch Barnett, as we saw last week. So does a bunch of other guys on our team.
Who amongst us doesn't have a brain snap in us? I know personally I have multiple a day.
When he simplifies it and doesn't throw a no-look pass, tackle two on the 20-meter line, he's doing fantastic. So, I don't know. I reckon he's worthwhile keeping around. I mean, he's got all the attributes. He's lightning out a dummy half when he actually runs and finds some space. So, I don't know. I don't get it either.
There must be something going on behind the scenes because the story just won't die. It seems to be every couple of months it comes up that he's been shopped around or asked for a release. Maybe he and Brownie just don't get on. He didn't like Brownie's wife's buttered chicken or something. I don't know. But yeah, it is a strange one. Well,
if he didn't like that, then he's gone.
Absolutely. So, and that's a reason. Brownie. Yeah, that's reasonable. If that's the case, then I'll allow it. Now, this one is a very good one from Josh Spiegelman, the Hebrew Hammer, our very own.
Hebrew Hammer. Is that what you do?
That was beautiful.
Thank you.
We haven't got it on the iPad anymore. I don't think so. That was excellent. Thank you, Sam.
No worries.
Now, pick the next Newcastle Knight to debut in Origin from any grade at the club.
Any grade. Well, I reckon Jesse Ramian, if he finally finds some ball out there, it's not a bad bet. Edric Lee's sniffing around there as well. And, you know, if Daniel Saifidi can do it, then why can't Jacob? I mean, he's the same human.
They're the same person, right? This is what we say every week. They're the same person. So surely if you put Jacob in, you'd have the same result.
Surely. It's
the beauty of getting twins. Like we always say, you get two for twice the price.
Unless it's like that mutual fund ad where one is like going up and the other one's different supers or something. I don't know.
Yeah, I didn't even think of those two. I picked a couple more. I've got Bo Fermor. He's playing in the Canterbury Cup. He came out of the Melbourne Storm system, got the New South Wales Rugby League Player of the Year last year in reserve grade, and I think the Knights Player of the Year in reserve grade as well. He's a Queenslander, unfortunately, but good hard-running back rower, so he could be a bolter for the Origin side within the next few years for Queensland. But the other one for me is Hymel Hunt. He's a Queenslander as well, and if Morgan goes down injured, like we believe may have happened, Queensland haven't got too many more centres to call on. So it could be a call to Hymel Hunt, who's been in excellent form this year.
He did a really good job to keep Moga out, Tautau out of the side, because Tautau came from Brisbane with heaps of raps on him. I mean, he's a dodgy as hell.
Oh, very.
And I also didn't like the way he treated Rossi. Do you remember that? When he was throwing those cutout passes into the crowd and giving Rossi a surf and not catching him? Didn't sit well with me, no.
Not to Nathan Ross. We love Nathan Ross on this show.
Exactly. Come back, Rossi.
Come back, Rossi.
Do the show.
Agreed. Now, this one's from my father, Gregor McNeil. Greg asks, why do you have potatoes in your mail sack? And now this is, of course, relating to the picture of the sack, which appears to most to be a potato sack. But I will clarify that as a good Irish boy, anytime you've got a sack, it has to have potatoes in it. So, yes, it's a mail sack, but it also does carry potatoes.
I've been sending you potatoes for years.
I know, and I love it. As an Irish man, I use it in everything.
Have you ever had a potato liquefy on you? Don't let it happen.
No.
If you leave them too long, they go to liquid. And it's the worst smelling thing you've ever smelled in your entire life. So if you've started to feel your potatoes going a little soft, get rid of it.
Get rid of them. Yeah. So you don't
or eat it. No, what I don't know.
See, because now for me, I always assume that when they turn to liquid, they ferment and become alcohol.
Oh, yeah. It'll mess you up if you drank it.
You didn't try and lick it off the counter or anything?
No, I was too busy like screaming bloody murder at the smell that was coming at me.
Fair call. All right, next thing we've got coming, Nagy will get this one right. Time for the news.
Oh,
All right, pretty quiet week for the news. We've discussed all the Origin stuff, but there's more to come. Nathan Cleary out for 4 weeks, will miss Origin 3 with an ankle injury. It has been cleared that it's not syndesmosis. Are you around the meaning of syndesmosis and what it is?
God, it just came up, didn't it? This it is came the year up out of syndesmosis. I know. China has got something to speak for the year of syndesmosis. But it's I don't know if it's a blow. Do you call it a blow? The Blues team?
I'm not too sure because I haven't been sold on Nathan Cleary's performances in Origin.
He's a steady Eddie.
He's a steady
Tackles
Eddie.
Tackles his ass out.
But is that what you need from a halfback at Origin level?
Well, if Maloney's running the shop and he's just there, I mean, maybe it is. But, I don't know. Penrith will probably feel it a bit more than New South Wales will. But, yeah, I don't know. It's,
we've got plenty to choose from. And yeah. Especially if Keary comes back. I think Keary and Maloney could be a devastating combination for New South Wales.
Just needs to get his head right, doesn't he?
He does need to get his head right, which is a tough ask when you get hit by Daniel Saifidi.
People always talk about that when we played the Roosters and the Rabbits, and they try to discount our wins.
Oh, they discount them at their own peril, though, Sam.
Roosters dropped Cooper Cronk for the game. That's their fault.
Mm-hmm.
And we killed Luke Keary. We did that.
We did that.
So, that's us. And then the Rabbits, we beat them without Ponga. You can all eat it.
Exactly. I agree. Those wins have been discounted by a lot of, the Sydney darlings of rugby league media. Yeah.
And I forget what happened in the Storm game. It's just a black blur.
Yeah, we won't talk about that one again. No. Now, Josh Maguire will miss one game for his... Oh, I've written hit here, but I think we should call it what it is. A dog shot.
He's a dog
man. A dog shot on James Maloney. Isn't he just... having a particularly grubby year. Like, he was already a bit of a grub of the game, but he seems to have taken his grubbiness to a bit of a new level this year.
You would have thought going to a new club, you'd try and just, suppress your grubbier instincts.
Yeah.
Try and ingratiate yourself with the new fan base or whatever, but nope, he's just eye gouging and headshotting and doing all he wants to do. He's probably still hanging that jersey out of the bus making the kids run.
You'd think, if not to ingratiate yourself to the fans, even just your teammates.
No.
Because you don't want to be hanging around with a fella like that causing trouble all the time.
What a bit of vision, though, when he came off that, when he got injured, when he did his calf and he came off and he was cold and the steam was coming off and he's ripping the tape off his head. That's the kind of Josh Maguire I can get behind. But...
Josh Maguire ripping his hair out.
Yeah, exactly. Injured as well is also good.
Now, next item in the news, Sam Stone has been released, effective immediately, I believe, to join the Titans.
Titans.
I think at certain points of last year and the year before, that would have been a big blow for the Knights, but it seems like at the moment we've got the depth and it's kind of a case of, I guess, that's where he's going to get his shot, being in the second row. We've got enough second row depth that we don't particularly need Stoney at the moment, which is a tough thing to say. He's a club junior. He's come through the junior ranks and made his first grade debut in 2017. I think he's played 18 games since then, scored a few tries. But, yeah, it's a shame to lose him. But at the same time, you can see why he would have wanted to move on.
Yeah, it's unfortunate for Sam. I mean, he had a pretty rough trot in those years where we were just getting hammered till at a post. So they not get rewarded to actually benefit off the fact that we've... It's a bit like when Danny Levi finally cracked the New Zealand team and then we got Slade Griffin. He just came and just took everything from him. So it's a bit sad for him. It's like we've had injuries to second rowers this year and his name just doesn't even come up, does it?
It hasn't registered. So, I think especially with Aiden Guerra coming back now, there's just not room for Stoney, unfortunately. Mm. We'll miss you, Stoney, though. And last one, speaking of Stone... Oh, no, wait. Rick Stone's not the coach of Fiji anymore. Speaking of Rick Stone and jobs that he's formerly had, Fiji will be entering a team in the New South Wales Rugby League Canterbury Cup in 2020. I thought this was a very interesting story.
Yeah, I like it. I like it very much.
It's, because I think the PNG Hunters have shown that expansion into the Pacific Islands can be a huge success, but obviously you've got to start in the lower grades, and maybe this could lead to... first grade spots down the line for more Pacific Nation teams.
Yeah, very much so. I really enjoyed Rep Round. I really enjoyed all the international games that they played. I love the Samoa PNG game. I thought it was really fun, and I love Benji having a cry during the anthem.
Wasn't that gorgeous?
It was beautiful.
That was beautiful. So thing of beauty.
I wouldn't mind even if they did make Origin every game on the Sunday and have a Rep Round every time and turn these things into trilogies. I would watch the shit out of that.
Like this idea. More rep footy is always a good thing, Sam. I think I agree with you wholeheartedly there.
Yeah, so I really look forward to it. And in New South Wales, they can only grow and get better. And, that means when you get to a World Cup, you can stop watching. You can start watching earlier in the season, earlier in the competition, rather than waiting to the end when the teams that will actually compete with each other will play each other. So, it's only a good thing.
All right. Well, that's all for the news this week, and that's all for the Joust, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for joining us, Sam. You've been a shining beacon in this this time of need for us, and we appreciate it hugely.
No worries.
Don't forget to check out our social media pages, Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, SoundCloud.
That's the one.
I've got SoundCloud. Maggie always misses SoundCloud, but I nailed it. Joustus, thank you very much, and we'll see you next week. Don't forget to get out and support the boys against the Brisbane Broncos on Saturday.
At the greatest pub in the land, if you
can't
get there.
Greatest pub in the land, the Commonwealth Hotel. Absolutely. If you can't make it to the game, get to the commie. They will, of course, have their courtesy bus running from, I believe, an hour before kickoff. They can take you right there to the game. And we'll see you there. Thank you, Jousters.
I did have the time of my life.
I feel like this was appropriate, given Sunday night.
Right on.